I have so many dreams. A beautiful house for my mother. A shiny new pair of shoes for myself. Shoes that I can wear to church on Sundays. But you know what my real big dream is? To be able to go to school someday.
Gusto ko po makapagtapos ng pag-aaral para maihawal sa hirap ng mga pamilya ko. Ako naman magpapaaral sa mga kapatid ko kasi minsan nakikita ko sa nanay at tatay ko na nahihirapan na sila.
Yung pangarap ko sa mga anak ko, makakapagtapos po sila sa kanilang pag-aaral para sa huli, hindi rin sila mahirapan kagaya namin na yung nadaanan namin, hindi rin nila madaraan.
Every journey has its beginning. And for the Erda Foundation, it all began with Father Pierre Tritz. Father Tritz, a Jesuit priest from France, was sent to the Philippines in 1950 as a minister to Jesuits who were expelled from China. In the years that followed, he pursued postgraduate studies, served as a chaplain for different institutions, and taught at various universities. These roles gave him a deep understanding of the country's educational needs and social issues. However, a study revealing the alarming dropout rate among students in poor communities is what ignited Father Tritz's dedication to making education accessible for disadvantaged children and youth. In September 1974, Father Tritz founded the Educational Research and Development Assistance Foundation, or ERDA, with a clear mission to keep underprivileged children in school. ERDA Foundation began offering financial assistance, school supplies, and support to families in need. Its flagship program, Operacion Balik Paaralan, started out with 6 beneficiaries enrolled at Juan Luna Elementary School in Sampaloc, Manila. Understanding that a holistic approach was crucial, ERDA expanded its efforts over the years to include family and community support.
Sa educational assistance, lahat ng mga bata, binibigyan namin ng mga school supplies, miscellaneous pay, binibigyan namin ng bag. Sa pag-o-organize ng community, ino-organize namin ang mga bata, ang youth, and ang parents. Sa pag-o-organize, i-organize mo kasama ang pagbibigay ng mga capacity building training sa bata, sa youth, at sa magulang.
We conceptualized mobile schools, yung mga catch-up programs, yung mga fiesta pambata, yung food always in the home, Comska. Yun talaga ang maganda sa ERDA kasi open for possibilities, hindi nakakahon ang mga programs. Every time merong planning, merong strategic planning, binabago-bago yung mga strategies para makapag-respond to the call of the times.
At the heart of ERDA's mission is the drive to uplift Filipino children and the power of shared passion. Father Tritz's infectious spirit united volunteers, supporters, and staff with a common purpose, forging bonds that went beyond their work. Over time, these connections grew stronger, turning colleagues into one big family.
Of course, when you meet Father Tritz, he's a very, very a holy man and a very inspiring person. When you see him work as hard as he does, as hard as he did for the children, you want to give your own share of the mission of ERDA.
Para kayo magkakapatid, masabihan ng problema. Yung mga tao dito, masaya pag magtrabaho, masaya ako na tumagal ako ng ganito. Maski hindi ka nakapag-aral ng high school, okay lang.
ERDA's history is filled with trials and triumphs that tested the resilience of its staff who have grown into a tight-knit family. Through it all, Father Tritt's inspiring presence has been the cornerstone of IRDA's strength, helping the organization turn challenges into opportunities for growth.
Sa mga staff na nagtatrabaho, dedicated naman po talaga, kaya lang minsan ng limitation, yun nga pong resources na we have. Pero gumagawa po ng paraan ng mga staff through linkages, referrals, and coordination. Hindi po sila tumitigil na dahil wala kaming resources.
Ang pinaka-main challenge talaga kasi physically talaga may problema sa akin. Bagamat ganun yung condition ko, siguro masasabi ko naman na itawid ko for 34 years yung mga programa na ibinababa sa community. Masarap sa pakiramdam yung may makakasalubong ko na, "Ma'am, isa ako sa naging beneficiary ng IRDA and here I am now."
IRDA's impact has spread across the nation, cultivating partnerships that encourage individuals to join its mission. Through collaborations with schools, civil society organizations, local governments, faith-based groups, and people's organizations across Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao, IRDA has transformed lives and ignited a spirit of giving.
So it's really a blessing to have IRDA Foundation because we have the same goal. We share common objectives to help the community, to help the young children, to promote quality of education. Initially, we started with 500 student beneficiaries in the province of Guimaras. Then that number grew to 700, then to 900 in 2017. But this year, we are proud to say or to serve 1,000 student beneficiaries from the provinces of Guimaras, Antique, and Iloilo.
An IRDA assistance is an entry point for education. Pwede ka makapagbigay sa kanila ng health and education seminars. Pwede ka makapagbigay sa kanila ng livelihood projects. Pwede ka makapagbigay sa kanila mga environmental projects. That's why IRDA assistance is one of our strengths during accreditation. So the Community Extension Services of St. Paul University, Iloilo, because of IRDA assistance, the CS is the flagship of the university.
What I'm happy about my organization now is that we have avenues where we can advocate for our causes. So I remember there was one time we had a chance to nominate an organization that we're so passionate about. I just wrote my nomination and I wrote about IRDA, how it helped me become who I am now and how it is helping millions of children today. And then luckily I won the Project Share Award and they donated an amount to IRDA which helped me send 40 kids to school.
Even na in pandemic, me and my junior educator, nag-conduct po kami ng tutorial sa community namin. Ang kinoconduct po talaga namin is yung reading, writing, and also mathematics. Minsan po nag-painting po kami.
In time, IRDA's programs have evolved to become more progressive, inclusive, and responsive in addressing the needs of children while extending support to their families and communities.
Napakalaking tulong po ng Homescap. Dito po ay tinuturoan namin yung mga parent na mag-ipon. And then malaki ring tulong po, kung panahon ng pandemic po ay kami ng pantry. Yung penalty namin, ginamit namin, binili namin ng mga pagkain, nagluto kami, tapos pumunta kami sa isang lugar na alam namin na kailangan nila.
Ang Comsca po ay talagang napakalaking tulong po. Hindi lang sa amin mga parent leader, pati sa komunidad namin. Natuto po kaming makisama, natuto po yung mga members na pahalagahan yung oras at lalong-lalo na pagtiwala sa bawat isa.
Tinrain ako ng IRDA para makapagturo. Malaking tulong talaga, ma'am, na yung pag-preschool teacher ko dito. Kahit hindi ako nakapagtapos, nakatulong ako sa mga bata dito. During pandemic po talaga yon, kasi hindi pwede makalabas para makahanap ng trabaho. Isang option ni Ma'am Yoli na bigyan ako ng tutorial sa mga kabataan dito sa komunidad. Dalawa yung
purpose talaga. Yung makapag-share ako ng kaalaman ko sa kabataan na ERDA scholars at saka yung sa sarili ko na na-finance yung pang-review ko para sa makapagpasa ng board exam.
Since after the pandemic, walang get-together o walang interaction yung mga nasa ERDA na parang ang hirap po kasing buhayin ulit nung participation ng mga bata. So ang naisip po namin, magkaroon tayo ng Children's Summit. Pagsamasamahin ulit natin yung mga bata since wala naman ng pandemic. Doon po namin pinasok yung pag-aware sa kanila, pagtuturo sa kanila ng mga karapatan nila. Para continuous po yung pag-build ng pag-upscale ng mga leader dito sa Basaycol.
In its 50th year, ERDA's light has reached far and wide, touching the lives of 950,000 children, their families, and communities. It has sparked hope and fueled change in countless individuals, leaving a legacy of transformation.
Noon, yung ibang kabataan, humuhinto, balik eskwela, ganun. Yung iba, nag-asawa po ng maaga pa kasi dahil po sa kahirapan ng buhay namin. Pagpasok ng ERDA po, tuloy-tuloy na ang pag-eskwela nila. Nagbalik eskwela sila po kasi mayroon ng ERDA foundation na nagbigay ng pag-asa sa kanila at pangangailangan po.
My father tsaka sa nanay ko po. Galing po kasi silang province. Siyempre po sa probinsya medyo mahirap po yung buhay. Wala pong nakapagtapos sa kanilang magkakapatid or sa both sides po yun. Achievement po. Both families na nakapagtapos po ako. Especially private school po. Na-scholarship po. And yung ERDA po yung naging gabay, naging guide po para po matupad yung pangarap ng both family po.
Noon na isa lang po akong simpleng bata, like di po ako nakikisalamuha sa ibang tao. Pero ngayon, pagsali ko sa mga ERDA activities, doon po ako na mold as a person. Isa po ako ngayong student leader, hindi lang po dito sa barangay, hindi lang po dito sa municipality, but also the whole province of Iloilo. And doon po ako naka-learn na dapat hindi ka lang dyan lang o hanggang dyan ka lang, pero dapat you should try to wander around you because maraming opportunity po. At yun po ang isa sa ibinigay sa akin ng ERDA Foundation.
Hinayaan ako ng ERDA na mag-grow sa foundation mismo. Pinapadala po sa mga iba't ibang lugar para matuto. And kung wala po yun, parang wala pong silbi. Kasi ang hirap mabuhay kapag wala kang pinaglalaban.
Right now, I'm a SK chairman in my community. And also with the ERDA, inspired me to be an early childhood educator. And makahelp po sa mga bata dito din to create programs and seminars na makakatulong po sa kanila.
When I remember, I would always look forward to opening of classes. Kasi alam po, may makukuha kong bag. It may be simple for others, but to us or the kids, every time we get that bag full of school supplies and then our new uniforms for the year, we know that it's another year we can push forward with schooling. It made me promise to myself, parang hindi man ako maging mayaman someday, but I will find a way to also do the same for other children.
We give back to the organization na tumulong talaga sa atin. Kasi without ERDA, walang Marlon Saneta. Kaya pag may mga activities na organized by ERDA, we supported that. We acted as resource person. I also wrote a storybook, Bayong ni Mama, for ERDA.
I grew up in a remote town in Iloilo, part of a very simple family. Both of my parents didn't finish college, and every day I am a witness of their struggle just to make ends meet. But ERDA's vision found its way into our community. They reach out to children like me, children who had dreams but no means. Through ERDA, I was not only supported in my education, but I was also given a chance to develop as a leader and someone who could be a voice for others. Where I am right now, what I have done or become, I owe it all to ERDA, to Father Tritz, to the old and new benefactors, and our ates and kuyas behind this foundation.
I see it really as a transformation. There was something that Father Tritz says, if you educate a child, you're giving them future. They did invest on me
hindi lang ako yung nag-benefit noon. It's the generations after me. My life got better, making me able to give a better life for my child. So parang, it's a blessing that continues. So sabi ko, if we can do this, if they do this to me, dapat, diba, pass it on.
Everything that I teach, lahat ng mga pwede kong i-share sa mga students ko, naranasan ko talaga sa ERDA. Kasi kung hindi sana ako nag-work with ERDA, I don't think mabibigyan ko ng justice yung pagtuturo ko, kasi I would never be able to simulate ba kung paano yung pakikipag-usap sa mga tao, paano maramdaman yung mga paghihirap nila.
You ask, is the work that we do worth it year in and year out? And I say to myself, if you change only one life, it would be worth it. And ERDA has changed a lot of lives during the course of 50 years. We are proud to have made a difference in the lives of children.
ERDA's inspiring journey mirrors the steadfast support of its partners and donors, whose unwavering faith and commitment have sustained ERDA's programs all over the country for the past 5 decades.
We have this community in our village, yung mga mami doon na mga kazumba ko, mga kakoyoga ko. I call the group ERDA Mami. I'm very grateful to have those kind of friends na we don't even have a second thought to give. So that's something that really something that I can look back when I get older, or we, as my friends become old, we did this for somebody. That's very important.
I'm so happy that my mom really introduced me to ERDA Foundation, because it was in that stage when I really focused on doing outreach. And now I am a fashion events producer, and whenever we have fashion shows po, the proceeds, also the beneficiary is ERDA Foundation. So it's not just about my passion for fashion, modeling. It's also like giving back to who made me this kind of person.
We are grateful to late Father Tritz for having given us inspiration to help the lives of countless Filipino children through education during past 35 years. We are grateful to all the hardworking elder staff. We have been able to sponsor more than 28,000 children so far. And even after closing down our group this year, ELDA Foundation will continue our fund in giving educational assistance to those in need. Thank you very much.
So, pasasalamat ito doon sa patuloy na tumutulong sa ERDA, kasi si Father, nung sinimulan ito, walang wala din. Maraming salamat. Kasi kung wala din kayo, katulad niya, whether na international or whether na foreign ito or mga local na mga donors, supporters ng ERDA, sa inyo, malaki yung tulong na ginagawa nyo sa paniniwala nyo na hindi lang sa ERDA yung dating ng tulong ninyo, kung hindi yung paniniwala ninyo na magkakaroon ng pagbabago dito sa mga tinutulungan natin, hindi lang ng ERDA, kundi mayroong mga maraming pagbabago pwedeng mangyari kung tayo ay magtutulungan. Let's continue working together, and we will continue to change and to make also a difference.
ERDA stands as a living embodiment of Father Tritz's vision and the tireless efforts of its staff, volunteers, and supporters. The Foundation's journey, illuminated by its mission and sustained by its community, reflects a powerful story of transformation and hope. As ERDA celebrates 50 years of making a difference, it remains steadfast in its resolve to extend its light further, nurturing dreams and fostering change for generations to come.